Hey guys, Schulte Phillips here with my video talking about the best and worst films of 2014. I made a list here. Basically, it's like my top movies, the ones that are the runner-ups, the ones that I think are worth watching as well, and then like the worst ones, then like the best worst movies, and then this like, two that like have been totally forgotten about, and I don't even know if they're ever going to even come to DVD or anything. I guess though, first, before we get started, I'll just cut quickly to me doing this video last year at the end of 2013. So here's a little bit like of what I look like back then. Now, of course, there's a whole bunch of movies that I haven't seen. You know, there's some things on here people might be surprised that I didn't include. There's also was a lot of pretty good movies this year. This year, in my opinion, compared to last year, I felt like there was a lot more, movies that were really pretty good. The changes. Well, the first one on the list is Under the Skin, and these are really in no orders, specific order, but these are the top ones, like the ones I say you have to see for sure, at least that I really liked. And I don't pick ones, though, that everybody picks. I have, like, kind of different tastes and kind of, I like kind of weirder things. But Under the Skin, the Scarlett Johansson film, which is, her as this alien, and then it's basically just her going around and, like, luring men into this weird lake and taking their skin and all this crazy stuff. It's just such a really surreal, beautifully shot, really cool movie. A lot of people didn't like it, though. It had a lot of mixed opinions. Some people really loved it, some people didn't. I thought it was really good. The next one is the Jake Gyllenhaal film that he stars in, Nightcrawler, which was him as a guy who was going around filming crime scenes. Another one that has kind of like the vibe of Drive, and one that I would highly recommend. I'm really looking forward to watching it again when it's on Blu-ray. Another Jake Gyllenhaal one, which is one that I feel like hardly anybody saw, hardly anybody knew about this one. And this is Enemy, which is another one of those really amazing movies with Jake Gyllenhaal. He's like this guy who ends up watching this movie one day and then sees someone that looks exactly like him as like an extra in the film. And he kind of becomes obsessed with this guy, wants to track him down and find him, figure out about his life, and then he kind of wants to, be in his life. It's a really cool, weird movie. The next one, I said some of these ones may have been released on video in 2014, or I'm not totally sure, but I know these are ones that I saw in 2014, which were pretty much released 2014. But the next one is the movie Joe with Nicolas Cage, which I really liked. I really loved the guy, too, who wasn't even an actor they found, who played the one's father in it, like in I think it was T-Dog, but he was amazing. He passed away recently, but he was so cool. The next one I really loved was a really indie film with Kristen Klebe, which was an amazing movie. Well, definitely one of her top movies performance-wise I really loved. And it's Proxy. And it's a pretty weird movie about this girl in the beginning of the movie who ends up, is pregnant, ends up attacked on the street, and she loses the baby, and she kind of goes to counseling, and then kind of becomes obsessed with one of the people in the group, and is following them around, and realizing there's something very strange about her, and then it takes a huge turn, and changes, and like, it's one of those like, ultra-violent kind of like, really out there, weird, different movies that it was, like I said, to me, when I pick like the top movies, the ones that I really remember and really stick with me and like live on is something that I really liked. The next one was Snowpiercer, which was a great movie set when the whole world, has frozen over in ice and the only survivors are these people who are on a plane, who are on a train, like this super fast train that was built. And it's pretty much the people who were on this train, kind of like, almost like a Titanic. It had like the luxury part where it was like for the really rich people. And then it had like the lowest class part. And it was kind of like all the people who are living on this train after all these years of this ice age outside. They have to try and still have food. The rich people are, doing what they're doing to try and keep up their lifestyle. And just a really cool movie about like all the just things really getting bad because it's at the end when food is really running out and they're not really so sure what they're going to do because, there's nothing left. The next one is another one that I really like, which is Boyhood, which was, shot over a period of, I think it was 13 years, and it's, they shot like 10 minutes or 15 minutes or something like that for the movie for 13 years. And it's about like a family and their life and mainly about this boy growing up and kind of all the things that happened to his family and the changes and divorces and fights. And it's just a really cool movie that really just puts life into a cool perspective and seeing things, throughout all those years. I just really liked it. The next one is the Ty West film, The Sacrament, which I thought was a, for a found footage movie, is one of the best found footage movies. Really cool concept about, these guys from Vice Magazine, going to do a story on the one sister who ran away and joined this cult. They get there and try and want to talk to the leader of this cult and why they're filming it, and weird things are, about the very weird things. People seem afraid of this guy, and it's a really just a pretty cool film. The next one's another one that hardly anybody saw, which was really cool, like science fiction, alien film, that Lin Shaye was in this as well, and it was The Signal, and it was about this group, these three friends that were like kind of following this hacker that was like messing around with them. They end up, tracking him, the signal out to the middle of nowhere in the desert, and then something happens. They see something, and the one guy is taken to this weird facility. He can't find his friends, they've gone missing, and he's like in this weird kind of hospital type environment, and there's very weird stuff going on here. Lawrence Fishburne is in it. It's just a really cool, alien kind of, hacker. What is with this group, and is, what is it? I don't know. I really liked it. The next one is The Rover, which was about a guy whose car ends up getting stolen, and it's Guy Pearce, and his car is stolen. He ends up, doing anything he can to get back this car and following them. It's another one of these ultra-violent movies. The next one is the Aubrey Plaza film, Life After Beth, which was a really great zombie film. When she ends up dying, and her boyfriend, played by Dan DeHaan, is really depressed about the whole thing. But then she ends up coming back to life, and her father's trying to and mother are trying to hide her away, and they don't know what's going on and how she's back and why this happened. And just a really cool kind of in the vibe of like My Boyfriend's Back from the Dead, but a little bit more of a polished film, but really good. The next one is one that's getting a lot of attention, but I really thought it was a Steve Carell's Channing Tatum film. Really like amazingly well acted film. Foxcatcher, about this guy who has all this money, and he ends up bringing Channing Tatum and his brother, and wants them to, be represent the, because they're wrestlers, and wants them to be his team, and he was trying wants them to get to the Olympics. Now this is the runner-ups. I'm just going to go through these a little quicker. Unbroken, which Angelina Jolie directed, which I really liked. And these are ones that are just as good, but just not my absolute tops. Saint Vincent, the one with Bill Murray. Calvary, The Skeleton Twins, Fault in Our Stars, which I need to see the extended cut at some point. Gone Girl, which was really good. I thought Tyler Perry did a really good job in that, a really different part for him. Fury, The Theory of Everything, Reese Witherspoon in the Wild, which is definitely one of my top favorite movies of hers, next to Freeway, and next to Election. Dumb and Dumber 2, which I really just love just because I was happy they finally did it. In Secret, which is one that I don't think anybody saw, with Elizabeth Olsen and the one from Harry Potter, but it was a really, really good movie. Palo Alto, which is really good, and Birdman. Now, these are ones that I think are worth watching, that are like, and of course, there's a lot that I'm sure I've missed that I really liked. But these are ones that I think people should really just see as well. This is another one nobody saw, The Pyramid. Which was a pretty cool. I liked it. I mean, it got some really bad reviews, but I thought it was great. Them going into this pyramid. I mean, I like, the mummy and those kind of things. I mean, at least the first mummy. So I like those kind of things, and it was kind of cool, found footage thing in a pyramid, and some cool stuff happening to me. Like I said, another one nobody watched it. The Interview, which I watched on iTunes. Had a lot of controversy behind it, but I actually thought it was pretty fun. Big Eyes, the Tim Burton film. Big Hero 6. Earth to Echo, which was a great film, a lot kind of like the Goonies kind of vibe to it. The Box Trolls, The Giver, which I thought was pretty good. I mean, I liked it. It had a lot of flaws and used a little too much stock footage and some of it, but still, I liked it. Tusk, which was the Kevin Smith movie, which is definitely worth watching just because it's so strange and Johnny Depp is so weird in it. The Maze Runner, which I really liked, and I'm really actually looking forward to seeing the next one. Lucy, the Scarlett Johansson film. That one got some negative, mixed opinions too, but I don't know why. The Double, That Awkward Moment, Date and Switch, which I really liked. That's another one that I don't feel like many people saw at all. Bad Words, Wolf Creek 2, and Edge of Tomorrow. And these are the ones that I would say are the worst that I just really didn't like. You know, the RoboCop remake, didn't care for that. You know, I love the original one. The Sylvester Stallone film that he's in, Reach Me, that was really pretty bad. Heaven Is for Real, The Devil's Not, which I was really wishing was good and was hoping it was good because I've always followed the stories and seen all the other stories on the case, but it just wasn't great. Tammy, which is probably one of the worst films I've ever seen. It was just such a waste of talent and just so bad. Same with Sex Tape, was like cringeworthy bad. Are You Here, which was hard, like just about not watchable. Before I Go to Sleep with Nicole Kidman, Colin Firth, that was her trying to remember. It's kind of like 50 First Dates, but it was so bad. Merry Friggin' Christmas, which was like I talked about in the last update, a couple updates back. Another one, like, it's just such a shame that it just wasn't that good. And another one that it was really upsetting that it was as bad as it was, because I just couldn't get into it. And, you know, I've liked musicals before, and I even liked Annie, the new one. But I didn't like this one, and it's Into the Woods. I don't know what you guys thought. Now, one, you know, two movies that no one saw, one, you know, and that kind of got forgotten about, isn't even on DVD, but came out like almost a year ago, and still not out, is Gin. If any of you guys have made the movie, let me know where I can buy it. I'll buy it from you. Same with this one. What was the other one? I forgot to write on here. Innocence. There's another pretty good one with the actress who looked like she should have played Brittany Murphy in The Brittany Murphy Story, which was a pretty okay. I mean, I liked it. It was another one I would love to get a copy from. I feel like these are ones you're just going to have to get them from the directors, Gin and Innocence, because I don't know if there's ever going to be anything for them. I don't even think they're on iTunes. And now the best worst movies, you know, like that's kind of coined from Troll 2 and the best worst movie documentary. And these are two of them that are the best worst movies of the year. Identical, which was terrible but amazing, and Left Behind with Nicolas Cage. Those are two, if you want to see the best worst movies, you know, movies that are, you know, kind of fun bad, but like you can't stop watching them, and you could watch them again and they kind of will live on for that reason. That's the one, especially The Identical and then Left Behind. So anyway, though, guys, that was my list of the best and worst movies of 2014. Let me know what your list is below, and if you guys do any videos, too, let me know. Definitely would love to check them out. Leave me comments below on what you thought about my choices. Anyway, though, guys, thanks again for watching and subscribing, and I'll see you guys later.